Good day, everybody. In this video, we will learn how to estimate relative density of coarse material from SPT tests. To do that, we need to know this relationship, which I highlight right now. And let's see how we can use it in practice. Let's look at this example when we have ground surface and we have, let's say, tests that we conducted 5 meters below the ground. So here, we know that the unit weight of this soil, and I think this soil is going to be sand, it's about 20 kilonewtons per square meters. And according to the SPT test, we have this N60 values equal 12. So this value is already corrected. If you'd like to know how to correct N values from SPT test, please watch my other videos. And what we need to do is to estimate the relative density of this material. Relative density is very important because it shows sort of the consistency of sand. If it's loose or dense or medium dense, it's very important for studies on liquefaction of sand or just to estimate the strength of this material. Okay, now let's see how we use this equation and how we're going to find this relative density here. So we'll see that here we need to know the effective vertical stress, and we also need to know this D50. So D50, it's the sieve size that passes through 50% on the curve, and we have the curve here. So now let's find this D50. We're going to look at percentage passing and going to find 50% here. And we see where it crosses the curve. So according to my rough estimations, it's about 3 millimeters. So this is D50. And now we're going to find the effective stress. So we know that the depth at which we perform this test, it's 5 meters. Let's make it a little more interesting, and let's introduce groundwater level. We're going to put it here, and we're going to say that the distance from the surface to the groundwater level is 2 meters. So now let's find the effective stress. We'll start with the total stress. Total stress at the depth of 5 meters, it's 5 meters times the unit weight of soil will give us 100 kPa. Now we're going to find pore water pressure. Pore water pressure, it's unit weight of water, 9.81 times this distance. So from the groundwater level to the point of interest, which is 3 meters, that will give us approximately 29.4 kPa. And the effective stress is the difference between total stress and pore water pressure. So 100 minus 29.4 will give us 70.6 kPa. Okay. So now we're going to use this a little bit complex correlation formula, and let's write it down what we have. So this is the relative density that we're going to find, and we're going to use percentage. That's why here we multiply by 100%. So now let's write down what we know. We know that N60 is 12. This is what we get from the SPT test, times 0.23 plus 0.06 divided by D50 we use in millimeters, NS3, and is going to be in the power of 1.7 divided by 9. And here we have another component, which is 98 divided by the effective stress, which we already found, it's 17.6. And everything is in the power of 0.5. To change to percentage, we multiply by 100. According to my calculations, the relative density should be around 41.8%. You can check it by yourself. So now what we can do, we can just look at the table. I provide a table here and look at the description of this material. We will see that if the relative density is 41.8, so it sort of falls in this range, we're going to have medium dense. And then we can also just check for SPT and 60 values. We had around 12, right? So it's in this range. So that give us good correlations. Well, thanks for watching this video and have a nice day.